All right, welcoming you back from that short break, and that means we're getting straight into the world of sports. Nicholas is joining the team for the feedback. Good morning to Nicholas.
Morning. Just a day left to the African Cup of Nations. I think the excitement hasn't been as good as it was in 2017 because it was for the first time in, what, 40 years? Mm-hmm. Now, the excitement will be around if Uganda Cranes can qualify for the knockout stage. 20th June, Days of Our Lives, 2019. Looking forward to the weekend.
A beautiful
Don't know about you, Willis. You're wearing pink.
I'm looking forward to the weekend because I think that Uganda is going to win its first match.
Willis, is that pink?
No, this is, it's pink. Right. So, in other news, I'm just excited that Uganda is going to win its first match, which I'm sure of. And,
we'll celebrate that.
Not when you're wearing pink.
Why?
Dudes don't wear pink.
It's a shirt. It's for men. It's color. Buttons are on the...
I'm just saying it's a color.
If you found out that your father was dating or slept with your girlfriend, what would you do?
No, if don't change the story. If you came into my room and found the room painted pink, you'd there will be questions around
this. Is a shirt. It's not
like
a room.
Dude, why would you be having a pink room?
Are you saying this is a girly set? Because that's pink.
I know it's a colorful set, by the way. You are wearing pink.
Lord.
Anyway, what would I think?
Are you trying to say that you have nothing pink in your wardrobe?
I have nothing pink.
You have white and black.
If you phone me with a pink underwear, just know.
Walai ko inaka satya. Kati otuga moine satiza white kumyo inaka.
White is a dude color. Pink ain't a dude color. Like, say it all you like. But anyway, I think that would be really mad for me if I found out that my father, my grown-ass father, would, come out and tell him I'm dating a girlfriend or my girlfriend. You said my girlfriend?
If you found out, he won't tell you, but you found out that they slept together.
Slept? Mm. That's a whole different level, my friend.
What would you do?
Not really do. Obviously, I'm not going to punch him or, I'll probably stand out to him and speak to him and give him a piece of my mind. But that's
what if
that's
he told
nasty.
You leave my thing alone?
That's nasty because that has gone from a B level to an A level.
What if you're talking to him and he says, Gwenik, you're my son.
And you need to grow up.
Grow up.
Leave my thing alone.
Leave
that is my woman.
I'm your father.
What would you do? Imagine you have a loaded gun on your waist.
I think the do thing wouldn't be really much because this is your parent, for crying out loud. I mean, if you did something that would be like inflicting harm on him, punching him or maybe shooting him or something, but I'll be really ashamed that he's my father and the fact that he is. Walk away from the situation.
So I can't communicate
can
over.
There is little you can do, but there is a lot you can say because, hey, that is now you speaking from the other side, your heart, and the story goes on, but it doesn't change the fact that he actually died into.
So you leave the kanyama for him?
I just leave it alone. Okay.
So do you eat his kanyama in case he has another kanyama?
No chance. I'll be thinking about him being on top of her. It's nasty, man. It takes you places in your head.
Being on top of Weber, Uganda Cranes seems to be ready as it gets, to be on top of DRC in the forthcoming game. That's, of course, one day to go. We did have some speakouts that were made yesterday. Could you take us through some of these highlights?
Well, Uganda Cranes, my goalkeeper and captain, came out to speak out yesterday to the media ahead of the Uganda Cranes Group A opener against DR Congo. Some of the pointers he put out there is how the first game against DR Congo will determine the team's fate at the Nations Cup Finals 2019. And to believe in Turkey's side because then it's quite important for any side to go there and get maximum points on match day one. That way it gives you the groove, the momentum, and above all the confidence to go on and participate and not make numbers in the African Cup of Nations. He also has that belief that they will go farther. That means that they will try and get out of the group. Many have ruled them out. Many have made the Uganda Cranes the laughing stock. And for Dennis Onyango Masinde, it comes out to say that will be no more. The football will do the talking as he goes on to, of course, root for his man and the captain he is, the leader he is. He will be, of course, out to eye for a clean sheet. DR Congo will be Uganda's next assignment. That will be Saturday, June 22nd. Their question will be, can they take all 3 points or at least a point against a side in DR Congo who are favorites on paper against the Uganda Cranes? For Uganda Cranes, having camped in Abu Dhabi for 3 weeks, taking out two international, playing out two international friendlies, one against Turkmenistan, which ended in a goalless draw. The other was against Ivory Coast. Again, for me, a build-up to the African Cup of Nations with the Sebre coming out to speak about improving the stats for the Uganda Cranes at the continent event, which is the African Cup of Nations. The quick look back from 2017, 3 goals conceded, just 1 scored, just 1 point, and of course, suffering 2 slim defeats against Ghana and Egypt. I want to believe that script, that story, might as well change with Willis wearing a pink shirt.
No, I think that Uganda Cranes is going to represent us absolutely well. I think they actually are going to go out of the group stages, and I'll hold you to your word and say you didn't support us. Now see your life.
I will see my
you
life.
You wear the white shirt.
But by the way, the third goalkeeper kit is actually a pink outfit. So yeah, you need that could actually carry some luck.
Blessings.
Mm. Uganda Cranes.
Yeah.
Let's cross over to some, of course, international football, looking at the FIFA World Cup Women's. Now, of course, we did have some teams that made it to the last 16. But on the other hand, Argentina seems to be held on a thread, waiting on who makes it and if they can actually qualify for this one.
Well, a late twist yesterday in the FIFA Women's World Cup currently happening in Paris, France, where Argentina, the South American side, came from 3-0 down to salvage a point against a side in Scotland. Of course, for Scotland, they must be kicking themselves in the head how they threw away a 3-0 lead against Argentina on match day 3 in Group D. Kim Little getting the opener for the Scottish side inside 19 minutes. And just when you thought that Argentina would actually bounce back and get an equalizer, it was Scotland again at it, thanks to Jennifer Betty making it 2 right before the right after the break, going into the second stanza of the game right there. A fine finish from the lady off her head in Jennifer Betty. Erin Cuthbert put the game beyond reach. At that point, 3-0 to Scotland. It did look like Argentina were nowhere close to a comeback, but miraculously, the South American side fought their way back in the game, and for Scotland, they allowed Argentina to actually get back into the game. Milagros Menendez pulling one back, a lifeline of some sort, right before, you know it, a gift of a goal from Lee Alexander to, of course, get Argentina back in the game. And a late twist in there, a penalty given thanks to VAR, and it was for Florencia Bosogundu. Now, Bosogundu missed the first attempt and then was given a second opportunity because then the Scottish goalkeeper went off her line. A similar scenario with the Nigerian keeper against France, where Renard Windy had to take that kick not once but twice. That was the penalty that was given after the referee checked VAR and later on pointed up the spot kick, where for Florencia missing the fast kick right there, and then later on the second, which was straight into the back of the net. VAR was consulted again, with the referee again cautioning the goalkeeper, you can't move before the ball is placed or kicked, and thus she managed to get a yellow card. And then of course Florencia striking home 3-3 finished. That means that Argentina will have to wait for all the other remaining group games to be played out for them to finish or to qualify for the knockout stage as a third placed team. Now, when you look at England, who had already qualified, they managed to finish on a high, a 2-0 victory against Japan. It was the young lady in Ellis White who scored a breast, inspiring England to all 3 points, 9 points altogether from the three games played out against Argentina, against Scotland, and now against Japan for Phil Neville's side, who confidently marched into the round of 16. Today we have a couple of games lined out, of course, with Germany as well, are set to feature in today's outings. What to see who will be facing who in the round of 16.
Could it be a high level of coincidence whereby we're having the women's team in Argentina struggling as well as the men's team, you know?
Well, I mean, it could be the situation, but the thing is, women's football is totally different from men. But what we've been seeing that in the last couple of weeks, women play like men. The agility, the aggression is actually similar to how the men play, and then you start thinking maybe the men's game should actually be upgraded. But well, I'm fascinated, I'm impressed with the way the women have been playing their game, the headers, the runs. This is 90 minutes of football, and it's quite interesting.
Let's cross over to some news coming in from all the way in Spain. Now, apparently something that started off as a rumor seems to be coming true after, of course, that the man himself, Enrique Luis, came up to, you know, quit as far as football
well,
in Spain is concerned.
The Spanish Federation this morning actually confirmed the departure of Luis Enrique, the senor formerly at Barcelona. He actually said, I'm stepping down from this role because he's so involved with the family. There's a current urgent issue currently happening with Luis Enrique's family, and he's been away since March. And that resulted into Luis Enrique throwing in the towel and quitting the role. His quitting had nothing to do with any pressure from the Spanish Federation. The Spanish Federation were quite clear that he stepped down on his own after deep thinking, or rather a very hard thinking of in regards to leaving this coaching role with the Spanish national team. That means that the young man, rather the gentleman in Roberto Moreno, who has overseen wins against Malta, Faroe Islands, and Sweden, will temporarily take charge as the Spanish boss with the Spain national team. We also understand that that could actually be made permanent if Roberto Moreno does well with the Spanish team. Of course, the Spanish team since 2010 are winning the World Cup in South Africa, haven't done quite well winning any major titles. title, but you want to be, you want to think having failed to reach the semi-finals, which was the last appearance for Luis Enrique right there, getting some handshake from the Barcelona Presidente. Was his last time out of the UEFA Nations League, not the kind of campaign Spain could have expected. But moving forward, Roberto Moreno could be the man to take Spain forward. This is the fourth coach at Spain to, of course, come into the job. Of course, Vicente del Bosco, after frustrating year after winning the World Cup. We've also had Julen Lopetegui as well. Now Luis Enrique stepping down. Now it's entirely up to Roberto Moreno to take this team forward, or to also eventually step down if the pressure gets to him.
Right, let's move away from Spain and look into some more news making headlines regarding the Copa America.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's just not happening for Argentina, of course. Yesterday, another frustrating campaign they had against the side in Paraguay. A 1-1 draw against the side that came out quite strong. They were solid right from the wide goal. They took it out. They took it out to Argentina, who are favorites right at the start. And it does look like the 14-time Copa America champions are likely to miss out on knockout football. Lionel Messi cancelling out the opener right there from the Paraguayan forward. And right before the break, you want to think that you thought that maybe Scolani's men would actually come out strong and try to get the result they needed after frustration against Venezuela on match day two yesterday. That 1-1 draw against Paraguay leaves them in a very tricky situation. Their hopes of qualifying for the knockout stage were dented, and moving forward, they've got to beat up on the guest nation in Qatar by 3 or 4 more goals and hope that Paraguay fall out to Venezuela on match day three, Colombia on match day three, as far as the Copa America is concerned. And likely, it's likely to be the case, because when you look at Colombia and Venezuela, Colombia are a much better side, but you can't rule out Venezuela to go out there and fancy them chances to qualify for the knockout stage. But as it stands, Argentina are in all sorts of problems. With all the quality they possess, you go in, Aguero, you know, Messi, they can't seem to get it right, and something must be fundamentally wrong at the side in Argentina. Currently, rock bottom in groups in the Copa America after 2 games played out. Colombia leading the pack with 6 points. Right behind them is Paraguay after yesterday's 1-0 draw against the 14-time Copa America winners in Argentina, and Qatar, the guest nation, in third place. They could just spoil it for Argentina if they get a draw against Argentina on match day 3. Later on tomorrow, this morning actually, the wee hours, we'll be having guest nation in Japan up against the all-time winners in Uruguay, who have come out to win it on 15 occasions, out to get 3 points and make it 2 wins in the Copa America.
Yes, yeah, Nicholas, for that amazing update coming in the world of sports. Now, we can be sure to catch a sportswoman later on today.
Yeah, 2:30.
And of course,
we get to return tomorrow on Friday.
They get to return tomorrow on Friday. But at Pabas, now we're going to go in for a very quick break. When we do get back, there will be more feedback coming in on social media regarding our lava later this morning.